The fifth unit is principal stresses and strains. What are the principal stresses? Whenever a structural member is subjected to load, either the uniaxial load or biaxial load along with the shear stress, inside this material of the member, at a particular point, we can have the three mutually perpendicular planes. Those are the three orthogonal planes. Generally, in a plane, there will be the normal stress and a tangential stress on a plane. But there exist three planes, three mutually perpendicular planes, where only normal stresses are acting without shear stresses. Such planes are called the principal planes, and those stresses, normal stresses, are called the principal stresses. So on the principal planes, no tangential stresses or shear stresses. Among these three stresses, principal stresses, one is maximum, another is minimum value, and another is intermediate value. These, the greatest stress is called the major principal stress, and the least stress is called the minimum or minor principal stress. So we will consider a small element here for a member. This is ABE. Let's take the tensile stress is equal to load by area, tensile force by area. The sectional area along BE is equal to A by cos theta, that is equal to A secant theta. So normal stress on oblique plane BE is equal to the tensile force component by area of the plane BE, that is sigma cos theta A by A secant theta. So this will, by simplification, we will get a normal stress is equal to sigma into cos square theta. Similarly, tangential stress on the inclined plane is total tangential force by area of that BE. So sigma A sin theta by A secant theta. By simplification, we will get sigma T is equal to sigma by 2 into sin 2 theta. So resultant stress is equal to sigma n square plus sigma t square under root. We'll substitute, we'll get this sigma cos theta. So whenever theta is equal to 0, we'll substitute in the sigma n. Theta 0 means cos square 0, cos 0 is 1. So sigma n is equal to sigma, and that is a condition. And in sigma t, theta is 0 means sin 2 theta is 0, therefore sigma t is equal to 0. Similarly, theta is 90 degrees, we will substitute its sigma n value, cos 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0, sorry, and sigma n is equal to here 0. Similarly, sigma t is maximum, the sin 2 theta will, if it is 1 value, then sigma t is equal to sigma by 2, we will get. That is, sin 2 theta is equal to 1 means 2 theta is 90 degrees or theta is 45 degrees. Similarly, a member is subjected to like principal stresses, two mutually perpendicular stresses, sigma x and sigma y, as shown in this figure. So normal stresses on the plane, oblique plane BE, we can take a total force normal to this plane divided by area of this oblique plane BE. So we take this sigma x acting on the plane BE. This can be resolved into two parts. One is vertical and another is horizontal. So we can take that sigma x BA into cos theta plus sigma y EA sin theta by BE. So by simplification, we will get this. Sigma n is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta. In the same manner, tangential stress on the oblique plane, also if you substitute these values, sigma x ba sin theta minus sigma y ea cos theta by b. So we will get sin theta by this. Ba by b is cos theta, we will get. Similarly, ea by b is equal to sin theta. So by simplification, we will get sigma t is equal to sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sin 2 theta. The same manner, we can find out the resultant. And the angle between the line of action of resultant stress makes with normal to the plane, that is called the obliquity. So tan phi is equal to sigma t by sigma n. Now we can take an example. At a certain point in a piece of elastic material, there are normal stresses 48 newton per mm square tensile and 32 newton per mm square compressive on two planes at right angles to one another, together with a shearing stress of 24 newton per mm square on the same planes. Here, if the loading on the material is increased so that the stresses reach k times those given, find the maximum value of k. If the maximum direct stress in the material is not to exceed 128 newton per mm square, maximum shearing stress not to exceed 80 newton per mm square. Here in this block, we will take sigma x 48 and the sigma y minus value, it is compressive and shear stress is 24. We take the general formula to find the principal stresses. Sigma n1 comma sigma n2 is given by this formula, sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus or minus under root sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus q square. Sigma x 48 tensile, sigma y is minus 32. Here we are taking sigma y minus 32 by 2 plus or minus. We will take minus of minus sigma y value plus 32. And we calculate plus or minus means two values are there. 8 plus or minus 46.65. So that sigma n1 is plus value, we will take 54.65 newton per mm square. Other time minus, we take minus 38.65 newton per mm square. Now, k is some coefficient. The maximum value is not to exceed 128 newton per mm square. That is the maximum direct stress. So, k into sigma n1 is equal to 128, we will take. So, that sigma n1 is equal to 54.65. Substitute here, k is equal to 2.342. Similarly, we can find out q maximum, maximum shear stress, sigma n1 minus sigma n2 by 2. So, substituting the values, we will get 46.65 newton per mm square. The constant into q maximum is equal to 80 given in the problem. So that we can find out k times, that is k is equal to 1.72.